Hi guys, so this is the next video in the chapter 1 series. Let's continue from where we left previously. So in the story we looked at the stage where people started to use machineries and where small businesses were turning into large scale businesses. So this process happened in what we called as industrial revolution. So this process happened where handicraft businesses turned into using machineries in their production process. So this was initiated in Britain and then gradually spread to other parts of the world. So with the industrial revolution, there were lots of changes in production, how business were done, and also affected the society. So in the production, the small equipments were replaced with large scale machineries. Then division of labor were in place. New production and technologies were introduced, so small scale factories were turning into large scale factories. So it also had an impact on how businesses were done. The overall usage of money became popular, then banking system, insurance were introduced, a considerable growth in transportation was happening. The communication industry and industrial, the postal services were all developed. So it also had a great impact on the society as well. So new cities were developed in Britain. Many people started to migrate from other countries to Britain to obtain jobs. Then pollution started to increase. With the increase in use of machineries, there were lots of air pollution, sound pollution, etc. And prior to the Industrial Revolution, many of them were employed in the agriculture sector. But they gradually started to work for factories. People were starting to move from an agriculture sector to a production sector. So earlier we came across a term known as division of labor. So division of labor in simple term means where the entire workload is divided into parts, and for each part there will be separate employees doing them instead of one person doing the entire process. For an example, in the garment factory, the purchasing of material is done separately, then cutting, designing and sewing and even packing, etc. are all done by separate employees. By doing so, the productivity will increase. The productivity increased will reduce wastages in the production process. It will also ensure that quality output is delivered. Since there is minimum wastage, we also can reduce the cost of production. So when we reduce the cost of production with the sales, we can earn more profits than what we used to earn earlier. As a result of that, we could increase our reputation among others. But this also brings demotivated employees because of the repetition of the work. It becomes a barrier for personal development. It would reduce is a chance of finding another job elsewhere because they are specialized in doing a small part of the big entire process. So they have to look for a small process available elsewhere. But it would be very difficult to find because a person who knows the entire process will be able to find a job quickly than the person who knows only bits and parts of that entire process. So that's it with this video guys. Please do like and share to learn and let others learn. Thank you.